Hello and welcome to From the Depths. Now today we are going to take a look at this little thing I have built. It's not really big. This is a monitor. This is inspired by World War II bombarding ships, like HMS Erebus, which I took a look and well, it's pretty much the same configuration. Monitors of World War II were pretty much support ships to support invasions and do bombarding missions on land. Obviously, in From the Depths, you mostly have to deal with enemy vehicles, enemy planes, enemy ships, enemy submarines, obviously, but this thing is powerless against a submarine. So this is not a bombarding ship. This is actually a pretty powerful anti-surface ship. Now, if we take at the general configuration, you will see, well, it's a heavy turret in the front, some light guns on the sides, and a dual purpose at the back. Now, let's do a view of the insides of the ship first, and then we will, well, see the general configuration from the outside. Command room, with computers, ACVs for shields, and the flare system. If we go down these stairs, we can access the main deck, which back here has this dual purpose anti-aircraft, anti-ship. Pretty fast firing gun. Uses no clips, only autoloaders and direct feeders. And well, gets the job done. It's not amazing, it's not great, but it's not bad. I mean, against flyers, it really does the job. So that's the main point. Now, if you go to the front, well, this is pretty much the reason of the ship to exist, which is the main guns. These are 400mm main guns. This is more or less 16 inches for those of you who use Imperial. A little bit less because translated into 406mm. I went a little bit smaller because this allows me to do cells of 5 components without going past 2 meters of autoloader size. So yeah, they are very powerful. You'll see them in action later. Then up here we have the anti-missile system. I could really put some advanced computer here to try to make it a dual purpose gun, but I don't want my dual purpose, my anti-missile systems to run out of ammunition when they have to shoot at missiles. These things have belt feeders, and belt feeders fire very fast, but when you need to reload, you are out for a long time. So these are dedicated anti-missiles. Very fast firing. Closing weapon systems are not amazing in Front of Depths, but helps. Between the IR flares and the anti-missile system, I can't fend, well, single missiles, 2 or 3 missiles, I can't deal with them. More than that, they are going to impact no matter what. So that's what's up there. Now, if we go below decks, you will get a general idea of the configuration of the ship. First, back here, we have the main AI mainframe. As you can see, surge protectors against EMP, isolated with wood from the metal, so EMP has a hard time finding a path towards its important stuff. Some repair bots back here, and this is quite important. Let's see if I can access it. Target prioritization is set to put a lot of value per range, so the farther the enemy is, the higher priority is going to be. High priority for fast and high targets. Low priority for everything else. This controls the the closing weapon system, but that one is automated against missiles, so whatever. But this controls the secondary gun back there. And it's set up to engage enemy flyers and enemy fast enemies first, because obviously that gun is going to hit more than the big guns against fast enemies. If you close this and close this and move these stairs, I close this, Now here is the engine compartment. This I designed it myself. I mean, I always can slap an engine in here and whatever, an engine which is not mine. But I want to learn how to build high efficient engines. And the only way to do is to fail and to build something which is not really great, but you get better each time you try. This one has inline superchargers on the bottom row and standard turbochargers up there. It's not extremely powerful, it's not extremely effective, but again, gets the job done. It's 2400 power and decent efficiency, I think. I mean, 200 is not bad. And yeah, enough power to keep everything running. I could do with a little bit more power, you will see it later, but yeah. Again, if you don't do stuff by yourself, you never learn. Now, under this armor layer here, down there, there's my ammo. I know it's not good practice to put the ammo and the engine in the same place, but this is a rather small ship, and I have to place the ammo somewhere. So I place it there. It's very well protected. So, thick layer of armor there, bottom layer of armor, on the sides, layer of armor here, and layer of armor here with a space in the middle. I mean, this is not battleship kind protection, but I think for a small ship like this, this is very well protected. At least it really holds enemy fire for long enough for the main guns to do their job. You'll see that later in action. Now, if we go here, you see a lot of compartments, again, to keep flooding and to, well, pretty much contain damage on the outer shell of the hull. Here we have the secondary AI mainframe. This one, which has the target prioritization here, has a high value per block and a high value per weapon, meanwhile the rest is very low. So this will engage enemy big things and heavily armed ships first. Obviously, this is connected to the main guns. Again, source protectors is also isolated, and here we have, well, pretty much an empty room to take hits and to store some repair bots. So that's how it is from the inside. Now the total cost of this ship is 40,000, which is costly for a ship this size, but really I couldn't find a way to make it less expensive without making it less effective. So yeah, anyway, this thing can't sue and destroy much bigger things and much more expensive things. So in the end, it's all about effectiveness. Building something that pulls about its weight. And boy, does this thing pull about its weight. Armor layout, as you could see, well, is a double layer of armor all around the place. On the thicker side of the hull is a layer of armor, air armor. On the places that I don't have enough space is armor. For thruster configuration, let me go back to the command room there. For thruster configuration, which means we can go at not particularly fast, but not slow either, 13 meters per second. This is more or less 25 knots. It's not the fastest thing around, not the smallest thing around. Monitors weren't fast in real life either, so speed was not a big concern. Obviously, stealth wasn't a concern either, so I went for active and passive sensors alike. Lots of them, lots of munition detectors to get the closing weapon system and the flares firing. Main mass detection here, secondary detection on top of the bridge. That way, well, more or less we keep them away from each other. This turret doesn't have a self-contained detection system, which I usually do. I usually put them, but in this one I didn't have enough space. Let's take a look inside the turrets. Well, as you can see, nothing of ammo on the top layers at all. It's all down at the bottom. Some clips, some ammo, again, not the most efficient design in what regards high rate of fire, because that involves putting ammo in places you don't want to put them on. As you can see, this is very down and low in the hull. Hard to hit, well protected, again with armor and spaces between it, so very well protected, lots of compartments. So yeah, in my experience, this turret never blows up. Mostly the enemy tries to aim at this place because this is where most of my ammo is. This and the rear, I don't know why, probably because there's an AI there. So the turrets keep on firing. And these turrets put a lot of heart on the enemy, you are going to see that later. More about the excuse me, configuration. A little hydrofoil here, just to help with the pitching. And to support the bow and aft mounted upwards facing propellers. And then to control roll, we have a very strong layer of ballast here to keep the center of mass as low as possible, and roll keeping big thrusters or propellers here and here. These are really needed because these guns, I have a lot of recoil absorbers mounted in it, but even then it still kicks like a mule. So when this thing is firing sideways without those propellers, well, you get a progressive tilt, and that's never good. So with this thing, this ship is just steady. I mean, it tilts a little bit, but not a lot. You can see, turns pretty decently, and doesn't tilt at all. So that's I'm pretty happy with that. Obviously, all this stabilization stuff is directed by PIDs. Which I have in the back. Yeah, I think this is more or less an overall look at all the systems on the ship. So let's see the guns in action. First we are going to do just a test practice, so I will explain how they work. Let's spawn, I don't know, something in expert, a ransack. And go and off. First, we see the shielding, which activates on enemy detection. Pretty strong protection for the front and the main guns. Pretty strong protection for the ammo. Not as strong protection from the rear. Now this is because, as I told you, I would make do with a little bit more of power, but the engine is what it is, and my power budget is pretty much what it is as well. I could put two lower strength shields, and probably I will do so to give at least some cover from the rear, but as it is, it works well. So yeah, shields, as you can see, very angled to in the bow and the rear to prevent, well, end on fire and the enemies there. So let me turn a little bit, that should be enough. Okay, now let's go there. Okay, these guns. The guns, as I told you, well, they don't have all the reloaders they could have, but they are hard to make it go boom because all the ammo is well protected. The way it is set to fire 8 or 9 salvos at a very fast pace of maybe 1 second between salvos, more or less. After that, it stands down for maybe 20 seconds to reload, and then it can fire another 5 salvos, more or less, and then it has to go into another reload cycle. This is done on purpose, because I want a strong burst of alpha damage to destroy the enemy weapons. Once the enemy weapons are destroyed, I can spend all the time in the world to pretty much destroy what's left. So let's demonstrate that on an enemy ransack. So we select the main guns, and we take aim at the main guns. And, okay, there we go. Yeah. So, 3 salvos, the enemy main turret, and holy, look at that. I have cut that thing in half. Now we come here. Oh, we missed that, but we didn't miss that. Yeah. So now the enemy is silenced. Now I'm reloading. Actually, I fired again. Well, it's already 2 damage, it's going down. Yeah, you can see the initial burst is monstrous. It's, I cut this thing in half. I'm not kidding. Literally, I cut it in half. Yeah. So let's take a look at some finer details on this stuff again. You will notice, and if you haven't noticed, I will tell you, this thing have no failsafe. No weapon have failsafes at all. Why? Well, because failsafes cause lag. And this is an alpha game. It's not very well optimized, which is okay, again, it's alpha. But the problem is my game is not exactly the best in the world. My computer is not exactly the best in the world. So in big battles I lag a lot. Really, frames go to hell. And that's one of the reasons why I'm not putting campaign let's plays yet. Because really the frames get very low and I don't really know if you guys want to see a campaign with low frames. Let me know in the comments. I mean, all it happens is that things slow down a lot. But that's been a pain with my cruiser. I mean, my big heavy cruiser, I have reworked it a lot. You will see that in another video. I have reworked it a lot, but I can't use it. I can't use it because it lags so much. My frames go to shit each time that thing fires. Well, that's the limits of my computer. What I'm going to do? I'm poor, I can't buy anyone, so whatever. In the meantime, what I can do is to try to get things done. So there's as little lag as possible, as little frame loss. And reducing computational things is a good way to go. And failsafes are very intensive in computational time. So, no failsafes, how do I avoid each gun fighting each other? Because obviously, this thing, if it turns too much, might fire on this gun here. Well, I have set, as you can see, these green lines mark the fields of fire of this gun. How do you do that? Well, you go to the turret down here, you engage the extra constraints for the field of fire, and you set your azimuth minimum and maximum. If you are fighting backwards, you also have to click on flip maximum constraints. So this fires at anything that's beyond 60 degrees to the bow there and there. So pretty much at anything that's behind. And at 60 degrees of displacement, it won't fire my stuff here. Same deal with this. These have field of fire of 180 degrees. From the front to the rear, as you can see, it's all clean lines of fire, nothing in the way. And this is also 120 degrees there and there. So that's the way I went around the fact that, yeah, well, lag is what it is. And I want to do as lagless ships as I can. And you can get rid of failsafes in most stuff. In some things like, for instance, missiles, depending on the setup, I still have to go with failsafes. But that's the way it works. Now, lastly, let's take a look at the shells I'm using, which should be back here, down here. Yeah, this is the shell for my main guns. 5 components. Again, is 400 millimeters. So it's one component is 400 millimeter long. Times 5 is 2 meters. I have a 2 meter long shell which fits in a 2 meter shell rack, and that's why I could make this thing work. Has 2 gunpowder casings, 2 high explosive, 1 composite head. Very big kinetic damage, very big explosive damage, and a huge blast radius. Also, it's decently fast. So, yeah, you saw those cells in action, you know what they do, right? And back here, we have the cells for the dual purpose gun and for the anti-missile system. This is for the 60 millimeter. You can see, well, enough kinetic damage, very high armor piercing. That's the job against small flyers and well, even against the small ships. It's a good support weapon. For the 36 millimeter, those are the stats. Still very high armor piercing. So yeah, It's also pretty fast, so that extra accuracy I get from the shells. So yeah, all around, that's the warship. It's time to see it in action. Okay, let's spawn it something, an expert onyx watch, an hourglass. Okay, there it is. Now let me take a look. Okay, we're already responding. This thing has heavy guns in the front and that's a very high rate of fire gun, so I'm going to target it. And I'm going to tell the guns to fire there. They are taking a little bit of time to turn, obviously that turret takes a while. The enemy is already firing. We seem to have avoided most of it and we are firing. Okay, first salvo, one hit, second salvo, okay, that thing is gone. We change the point of targeting on the front to target those guns. Enemy cells incoming. Well, you can see both that I'm totally mauling this thing. Look at that. And now we are reloading. Now we are in the reloading cycle, but no big deal because the enemy is not fighting anymore. We have disabled all the weapons. And yeah, you can also see the problems I have with the frames. But yeah, it's what happens. Not a lot I can do to avoid it. Well, that was a very good hit. That was a very good hit. One cell in each turret. Let's keep on doing that. Another shot coming. We are again. Okay, let's switch from manual and into automatic. Let the AI fire on its own. We are already put him at 81% and we are at 100. Have taken some superficial damage, probably that advanced cannon caught some hit on me, but as you can see, nothing destroyed. Now the AI is turning away because I have it set to 800 meters broadside, more or less, but we don't need to stay at 800 meters, so I'm going to turn it and yeah, we are going to pretty much finish this thing off. And he's defenseless because I took all his weapons. He has still one gun in there in the back, but so far he can't actually come to the axe of fire. I'm going to, I don't know if I want to manually target it or not. So far is the AI firing. I'm not touching anything at this point. Yeah, frames, I'm going to see it. Okay, I'm going to manually target this thing. Fire at that turret. It's a little bit masked, but we are going to open our way to that turret on our own. Okay, main guns firing. Big detonation. A little bit of loss of frames. Second hit. Okay, that, I think that disabled the turret. Yeah, it did. So the enemy is powerless right now, has no weapons. And now it's just a case of finishing the job. The enemy is at 70%. And yeah, he simply can't do anything. All I have to do is to execute him because it's what I'm going to do. Okay, turret is reloaded, opening fire again, and wow, look at that. The amount of damage this thing puts out is quite staggering, to be honest. And those are only two guns. Now think of a proper battleship with 8 of those. Yeah. And probably with a battleship it would have more space for more autoloaders and clips, and the rate of fire would be more consistent than this. Because this is kind of burst damage and then you have to wait. But when the burst damage does what this thing does, there's no room to complain, right? More hits. Yeah. So yeah, this is just a case of yes, waiting it to be destroyed because simply can't do anything. Meanwhile, the secondary gun is just fighting and pinging away. Look at those explosions. That's quite staggering, to be honest. Now, obviously, a lot of people don't use high explosive right now. I'm reading that in the forums at least because they say the ammo goes boom. But the ammo goes boom because you place it in wrong spots. If you put it in the right spot and you protect it well, you can't use this kind of ammunition without too much of a problem. Obviously, if your ammunition goes boom, it's goodbye. But that's why you protect it well to begin with. So, yeah. Okay, the enemy is spawning, so... that was a victory. And we weren't even touched. That was an expert on its warship. That's quite some feat, to be honest. But we are going to face something bigger. Another expert design, an Alcázar, or Alcázar, or whatever. In Spanish is Alcázar, that's a Spanish name, that means fortress, actually. Or a kind of fortress. Okay, let's take a look at that thing. Well, that thing is quite huge. I don't know, that might be too much. Well, those are the fish. Oh, it has a laser! Has a laser which is targeting my weapons, but well, at least some cells are connecting. Some of them have been intercepted and destroyed off. As you can see, well, not right now because that salvo went past. Okay, front guns are pretty much destroyed. Let's try to target that side one. The top one should be out. Look at the lasers are detonating my cells. That's quite not nice from them. Okay, let's target that topside gun. We are reloading right now. I have stowed a little bit of damage there, I think. Yeah, I think so. Okay, we are still reloading. Yeah. And that cell is going to... yeah, connect. Destroy my aft guns. Look at those lasers destroying my cells. What an ass! What an ass! Don't do that! Okay, that... top turret seems to be done. No, not yet. Still there. But yeah, should be done already. Yep, that turret is done. Yeah, but lasers are still destroying my weapons. What? An ass of a ship. And has some side guns as well. Ooh, okay, I need to finish off that four turret. Okay, that cell goes there, exploding. Well, that's why I have 2 layers of armor, to stop that from reaching my engines and my ammo. I don't know if I can really finish the weapon of this thing, especially because of that laser. Damn it! Okay, another hit on my rear. But my guns are still firing, and as long as my guns are firing, I'm going to shoot at that top, because I think the anti-laser is there. Okay, that's a nice deflection from the shields. Those 2 hits were nowhere near the point I'm aiming at. Now we are coming closer, but still that anti-laser and that laser system is on that top. Want to destroy... well, whatever. Let's face and destroy those guns, because those guns can hit us. Ooh, strong hit in the area of our turret. But again, armor contained it. No big explosion, no ammo going off. Turret still operational. Lasers still shooting on my shells. God. Yeah! Damn it! And we are still getting hit. But if we disable that turret in the rear, I think we have this. That side turret. Okay, something really big exploded there. And as you can see, the frames are not exactly the best in the world. But yeah, it's the way things are. Okay, that hit might have helped with that turret. Oh, that laser, man. Lots of explosions, but those are mostly... there, that hit might be enough. No, not yet. The turret is still not out of line. Now it should be out of line. Is it? Is it destroyed? Did I get it? I think I did. So let's switch for the other side. Has more guns there. Well, actually, we are not facing there. So actually, we can try to focus on that laser system. I don't know. Let's see if we can get cells past there and destroy those guns. Because right now he can't fire at us. Has no guns. There, that's what I wanted. That gun is out. And that's what happens when you hit an ammo rack. And that's a ground cannon, by the way. Okay, let's take a look At well, yeah, we have some damage. The hole is open there, but contain the damage perfectly. The inner layer is standing. We have an opening in the aft area, but nothing that compromises our firing ability. Well, the rear turret is gone, but the rear turret is a non-factor in this engagement. And we are still putting a lot of fire on the enemy. Yeah, as I was saying, that big explosion before was cram ammunition. Cram ammunition doesn't go off nearly as strongly as advanced cannon ammunition does. So yeah, putting ammunition in places you are going to get hit at is never a good idea. Okay, let's try to disable this turret. Lots of explosions. And yeah, that turret is pretty much gone, I think. And more and more and more explosions. Come on, that turret should be destroyed in no time. And I'm getting tired of that laser, so I'm going to... Yeah! Finally, I'm hitting the superstructure. The node is still intact, however, so we need to put more fire on it. As you can see, it's burst damage, several salvos, and then takes a little bit of time to reload. But it's effective, and that's what counts, right? Okay, something coming. And there goes, finally the laser system is off. Okay. Now all we have to do is to finish the job. Okay, let's get rid of the AI. I don't need to stand off anymore, so I'm going to manually come closer for the kill. And as we turn in, we are going to re-engage there. Some good hits. There's still laser going. I saw some laser going off. I think there might be some nodes in that side of the hole. I don't know. Well, for now, the cells that are coming to this side are enough to hit. Yeah, there's a node down in the left. In the right, we seem to have destroyed it a long time ago. And this is almost 2,000 resource points. So it's 5 times my ship in an expert design from the Onyx Watch. And look at that. It's pretty much demolition work from here onwards. It's taking a little bit of time because it's a ship, it's a huge ship, it's 25,000 cubic meters of ship at 2,000 RP, but look at that. And we come close and pretty much demolish it at will. And as you saw, well, we stood a quite strong barrage of fire at the beginning, but the armor held very well. That's why I say, well, this ship obviously has nowhere close or anywhere near battleship protection. But to hold on fire until the guns really start tearing, yeah. Yeah, it does. And we even got a direct hit in the turret area, but yeah, who cares? I mean, with decent enough protection, we held the damage. Guns kept on firing, and there's still a gunfire in there. One second. Yeah, no longer guns firing there. Nope. That's a big nope. Denied. So still have some guns. I mean, just the degree of damage those cells do. Yeah, there's still a turret there, but no weapons. Yeah. The size. Look at that. Okay, there was a last laser node, and now it's gone. And I think it's spawning, or it's close to. At any rate, the size of the explosions is staggering. It's demolishing job. Look at that. They're like mini nukes going off. Very, very, very effective stuff going on here. Yep, it's two damage. It's spawning. So, yeah, what I'm going to say. This is a ship which costs 5 times as much as mine, and it's an expert design. Obviously, I'm not going to try to my luck with a bulwark or something like that, a godly design, because I don't think a ship this small can take on one of those. But for the coast, it's really, really, really effective, or at least I think so. So, yeah, well, I hope you enjoyed this video, I hope you enjoyed this ship and the fights. As always, thank you very much for watching, guys, and see you later.